This is the synchronous generator example, and using this example I would like to demonstrate new features related to harmonics calculation. In this generator, the magnetic field is induced by the rotor, but since there is the stator made of steel and there is the slots with the winding, you can see the magnetic circuit is not symmetrical. There is gap between magnets, there is ferromagnetic material and diamagnetic material, again ferromagnetic and again diamagnetic. If we build the contour in the air gap and take a look at the flux density distribution, we will see that the flux density contains a set of harmonics. These harmonics may generate eddy currents in permanent magnets. These harmonics are responsible for the noises of electrical machine. So it is important in some cases to calculate harmonics of the magnetic flux density. Now, again, to demonstrate that QuickField is really easy to use, I will create a new problem. Synchronous motor. The model class is magnetostatics, and the length units are millimeters. The motor length, in our terms, the thickness is 50 millimeters. It's a small motor. Now here I should draw the geometry model. In fact, I already have the DXF file, so I will simply import the geometry from the DXF file. Now this is the geometry model. Here I should assign physical properties. I should assign labels and then physical properties to each object. This is the air. Well, let's do it simpler. Let's call it all the winding. This would be the air. This would be the steel. This would be the permanent magnet plus directed outward, and this would be the permanent magnet minus. Let's check now. Air, permanent magnet, steel, winding. Again, I will assign boundary condition at the surface of the generator. I believe the magnetic flux is incorporated inside the core and no magnetic flux penetrates the core and leaves outside. So at the surface of the stator, there is no magnetic field. Now let's specify physical properties for each object. For the air, I specify 1, for the permanent magnet. I specify the permeability of the magnet, the coercive force, and the direction. For another pair of permanent magnets, again, I specify the permeability, the coercive force, and the direction. For the steel, I specify the permeability. And for winding, I will not specify current for now. I specify only the permeability. So this is the synchronous motor rotating with no load, no current. Synchronous generator rotating with no load, no current in the winding. And for the external boundary, as I said, I specify zero magnetic potential. Now let's build the finite element mesh and run the analysis. You see, this is the magnetic field distribution in the motor. Now let's take a look at the field distribution in the air gap. I will build the contour in the air gap. And would like to take a look at the flux density distribution along this contour. You see, this is not a smooth line. There are fluctuations caused by non-uniformity of magnetic circuit. There are slots on the stator, so there are fluctuations in the magnetic field. I would like to calculate the harmonic spectrum of this plot. QuickField has the built-in tool, the harmonics browser. Here you should specify which value you would like to analyze. And it will give you the first harmonic amplitude and the high harmonics magnitude and the phase. Well, in previous version, the number of harmonics was limited to 100. Now, in QuickField 6.3 service pack 2, the number of harmonics could be up to 1000. Why that's important? Again, now let's take a look at the flux density distribution. With green line is depicted the original flux density distribution, and with the blue line is the approximation with 5 harmonics. You see, there are more than 5 harmonics. I can increase the number. This is the approximation with 10 harmonics. This is the approximation with 20 harmonics. With 24. With 50. But you see, it's still not enough. Some elements, for example here, are not well approximated. Well, 80, not enough. 100, almost here, but still not enough. Now it's better. 500. 1,000. This is the close approximation of the initial distribution, flux density distribution with 1,000 harmonics. You can see all these harmonics. You can see all these harmonics in table, and for each harmonic, get the amplitude and the phase angle.